Well, it's another beautiful, crisp winter morning here at Holden Beach, and it's a joy to welcome you. You come together once again to worship the Lord. It's always, always great. The big news now, of course, is have you got your shot? Are you scheduled to get your shot? Are you going to get a shot? So shots are in the news. So if you are planning to get one, I hope you either have received it already or you're in the process of getting it. Mine is scheduled, but it's so late the pandemic's going to be over by the time I get over there to get my shot. Yes, but that'll still be good news. But at any rate, we are so glad that you're here today. It's always wonderful to have you. If you are a regular visitor, if you're considering being a member here at the Holden Beach Chapel, there are membership forms out in the vestibule area. We'll be happy to get you one. Remember, you do not have to give up your membership at your home church, wherever that may be, to be a member here, but we welcome you at any time that you feel like that you would like to have a vested interest in the life and work of the chapel. We are always glad to have you. Now this morning as we begin our worship, let's go to the Lord in prayer. God, your unchanging nature provides strength to us. We know that you don't change, Lord, but we do, and it's not always for the better. Give us, Lord, a steadier approach to the life of faith so that we might better know you, know who you are. And then in knowing you better, Lord, maybe we can serve you more faithfully. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Good morning. I'm reading today Psalm 62. 5 through 12. Yes, my soul, find rest in God. My hope comes from him. Truly, he is my rock and my salvation. He is my fortress. I will not be shaken. My salvation and my honor depend on God. He is my mighty rock, my refuge. Trust in him at all times, you people. Pour your hearts out to him, for God is our refuge. Surely the lowborn are but a breath, and the highborn are just a lie. If weighed in balance, they are nothing. Together, they're only a breath. Do not trust in extortion or put vain hope in stolen goods. Though your riches increase, do not set your heart on them. One thing God has spoken, two things I have heard. Power belongs to you, O God, and with you, Lord, is unfailing love. And you reward everyone according to what they have done. The word of God for the people of God, thanks be to God. Please pray with me. Dear God and Father, we thank you for loving us so much that you gave us your Son, Jesus Christ, who showed us how to live our lives so that we, his followers, can proclaim loudly his good news to others. Your faithfulness to us, we know we don't deserve, but know that your forgiveness to us is never ending. We pray today for healing. We, our loved ones and friends, need your touch. This country and the world are suffering with sickness, hurting, mourning, and need you greatly. Please let us always remember that you are there, only waiting for our prayers, asking for your help. We thank you, dear God, for this chapel and its community of believers. We are so blessed to live in this wonderful country. And thank you for your gifts of love, music, nature, the beauty of your creation, and especially for your Son. In his name, we pray his prayer. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread. And forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom and the power and the glory forever. Amen.
May we please stand now and sing together, O Worship the King. Please stand, we sing. Pray together, please. Oh God, we bring you these gifts that represent that partnership that we share with you in proclaiming the gospel to the world. Give to us a sense of our unrecognized abilities and our many opportunities, and then give us the heart to be good stewards of your grace. Amen. Thank you. It's an honest pleasure to welcome Dr. Harold Custer to our pulpit today. He has been coming here longer than most of us have. He has been coming for 33 years. He is one of our regulars, one of our standbys, and it's a delight to have him. He's living in Kentucky right now, but he has been serving in Florida, in West Virginia, and in lots of areas. He has done lots of things that are near to my heart, and that has gone on mission trips in various countries. That's a delight. He and his wife, Kay, it's always great to welcome them here to the chapel, and this year is no exception. At this time, Harold, the service is yours. God bless you.
Thank you. I told the fellows back there that it's their job to make me sound good. And so I'm trusting that that will work here this morning. Reggie, you have done something this morning that I don't believe I have ever heard. He directed the choir, and there was not one mistake in the bass section.
That's right. That is unusual.
And there wasn't one in the tenor section either. Most of the mistakes come from the tenors. It's so good to be here. Kay and I have enjoyed years of coming to Holden Beach. You know, we've talked about the fact that in light of so many different changes in our lives, going from just Kay and me, the original two, to having one child, and then 6 years later we had another son, and the changes that take place in our lives throughout the years, the one constant in our lives has been Holden Beach Chapel. And I can't tell you how many times we've walked this beach and asked God to give us direction in times where we needed to make some decisions. And we've given him thanks for what he has done for us year after year. I will confess, as with all of you, I've never experienced a year like 2020. And I hope we don't ever do it again. But it's so good to have you here. It's just a thrill to see you here this morning. You are the cream of the crop. I know. And it takes effort and courage to come to church these days. And I thank you for that. The scripture I want to share with you is the 10th chapter of John. Jesus is talking, and he says, "Truly, truly, I say to you, he who does not enter the sheepfold by the door, but climbs in by another way, that man is a thief and a robber. But he who enters by the door is the shepherd of the sheep. To him the gatekeeper opens. The sheep hear his voice, and he calls his own sheep by name and leads them out. When he has brought out all his own, he goes before them, and the sheep follow him, for they know his voice. A stranger they will not follow, but they will flee from him, for they do not know the voice of strangers." Father, thank you for these words from your word. Speak to us now in these next few moments the message you have for us. We'll give you the praise, honor, and glory for all that's accomplished this morning. For we pray in Jesus' name. Amen. Have you ever noticed how names and recognition seem to impact us in powerful ways? Kay and I were making one of our many trips between Florida and West Virginia a few years ago, and we stopped in a city that you probably know, Charlotte, North Carolina. We stayed at the La Quinta Inn there. And the next morning when we got up, we went down to the little breakfast nook there to have breakfast. While we were eating breakfast, I looked across. across the room, and over next to the wall was a couple that I recognized. Dr. and Mrs. Shank, Jack and Joyce Shank, were there. And I watched them for just a few moments, and they were seated there across from each other. They had their cups of coffee, and they were kind of looking into their cups, and they weren't saying anything to each other. They just looked dejected. They looked lonely. They looked discouraged a little. You know, just not having a very good morning. And I said, "Hey, we've got to go say hello to those people." For you see, just a few months earlier, Dr. Shankle and his wife were leading a pastor's and spouse retreat up in West Virginia that Kay and I attended. He was a retired district superintendent in the Church of the Nazarene. That was when I was working with the Nazarenes a little. And we had a great time with them. Wonderful people. And so after we finished breakfast, we went over. "Dr. Shankle, Joyce, good to see you this morning. Harold and Kay Custer, we were just with you there in West Virginia just retreating. I tell you, when I called their name and they looked up at us, they came alive. I've never seen anything like it. It was a transformation right there before my face. They started talking like they had never talked before. They were treating us like long-lost relatives that they hadn't seen for years. And oh, what a great exchange that we had. It was just marvelous." And you know, when preachers get together, sometimes you start dropping names of mutual acquaintances. Well, he'd mention the name. "Oh, yes, I've worked with them in certain areas and so forth." And I dropped the name Orville Jenkins to him. Well, Orville and I had been colleagues in the Florida district. We were pastors down in Florida together. Good man. I liked Orville. He later went on to become a superintendent. Just a good man. Well, Jack Shankle, he knew Orville. And it wasn't long until he said to me, he said, "Have you heard Orville's ski trip?" I said, "Well, no, I haven't, but I knew I was going to." And he started to tell me about a ski trip that Orville Jenkins took a number of years ago. He said when Orville was a single man, early in his ministry, he pastored, he was in the Midwest someplace, and he had a youth group that he would always take to Vail, Colorado to ski. It started out kind of small, and then they just kind of grew, and everybody looked forward to it in his church year after year. Well, this particular year, they were going to go, and there was a lady in the group. She was, I want to be kind here, you know, she was a little overweight. secretary of my church, she called this hospital that I've had somebody else in the hospital that I needed to see, and they paid me. Isn't that amazing? I heard my name. Carl Hurley is a Kentucky comedian. And one time, Carl Hurley, I heard him say, he was in a hotel, and he said, I had them paid my name just so I could hear it. We like to hear our name. you know, he might even have something for us to do this afternoon. In this kind of a situation in which we find ourselves today, in a world that is so isolated, you know how many lonely people there are today? And I know there are people that you know who would love to hear you call their name. Pick up the phone and call them. Write them a note. Get a hold of somebody who needs desperately to hear their name this morning. What's he saying to you? Whatever he says when he calls your name, my advice is, say yes. He never led me astray. Every time he's asked me to do something and I've done it, there's been a blessing for me and whoever it is that I'm going to see. Tommy Walker in 1996 wrote a little song. I'm going to quote the chorus for you here this morning. He knows my name. He knows my every thought. He sees each tear that falls and hears me when I call. He knows my name. We know his name. And in this day and age, we need to communicate back and forth often. Often with him and often with each other. I wish I could call all of you by name this morning. In heaven, I will. We'll all have name tags then. You're important. And he knows. Your name. Let's pray to you. Lord Jesus, how we rejoice this morning that you know our names. We're asking you now to speak our names and call us to do your will. Help us to listen. Help us to hear your voice. Help us to hear our names. And help us to say yes to all that you have for us. For it's in your name, the name of Jesus, that we pray. And all of God's people say,
Amen.
Let's stand and sing our closing hymn, Savior, like a shepherd, lead us.
In thy pleasant pastures feed.
Thank you for being here. What a joy to see you again. What a joy to worship with you. And now may the saving grace of the Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God the Father, the fellowship, and the communion of the Holy Spirit rest and abide with each one of you.